I'm James O'Barr, artist, writer of The Crow, and you're watching Drinking with Comics.
This is amazing. So Reinhard Kleist,
Kleist.
He did, so it's a Nick Cave biography in graphic novel form. It's black and white. It's fucking gorgeous. It reminds me a lot of Eddie Campbell's Alec, The Years Have Pants, which is his kind of autobiographical graphic novel. The quote on the back of this, by Nick Cave, Reinhard Kleist, master graphic novelist and mythmaker, has yet again blown apart the conventions of the graphic novel by concocting a terrifying conflation of Cave songs, biographical half-truths, and complete fabulations in creating a complex, chilling, and completely bizarre journey into Cave world. Closer to the truth than any biography, that's for sure, but for the record, I never killed Eliza Day.
Cave world?
Dude.
Nick Cave is calling it Cave world.
So, there's five chapters. They start with him in, you know, primary school or whatever, and it goes obviously through the Boys Next Door, the first band that turned into the Birthday Party, which might be my all-time favorite band, and then it goes into, and I was always kind of off on the timeline, so they go to they get fed up with the scene in Australia. Cave brings them to Berlin. They hear Enstrasende Neubauten, and it changes Cave's whole approach to everything. He doesn't want to do the Birthday Party anymore, and he starts writing a novel, The Ass Saw the Angel. And out of this is the Nick Cave and the Bad Seeds is born. And it's just great. It's first chapter. They're all named after either, so it's the Hammer song, and then Where the Wild Roses Grow, which is one of his most famous songs. It's the duet with Kylie Minogue.
Yes.
Oh, that's good.
Just
that's
after Red Right Hand.
Yeah, it's well, it's
that
on
was
Murder
on her album.
It's on Murder Ballads. It might also be on her album. It's possible. It's just it's so awesome. And there's stuff on here I didn't know, or like, you know, like I said, I was confused on the timeline. It's goddamn, it's just so cool. And they do this thing where like when it starts with the character of the Hammer song, which is a song on The Good Son from 1990, Bad Seeds record, and you're kind of in the world of the song, and then you see Cave as like a character in this world, and then it pulls out, and so they do that a couple times. It's really, really cool.